Hey, an idea popped in my head. I just started to wonder, where does my favorite character, Mokujin, sit on a tier list? Is he actually good? Is he bad? It's kind of hard to figure that out because, well, he's a mimic character. To me personally, he's triple S tier. But I want to be objective. But how do I do that? So I started brainstorming. Mokujin is pretty unique in Tag 2, thanks to the bound system, the intricate combo system, and also his static frame. This gives him some positives and negatives compared to whoever he's copying. So I decided to compile and tally up all these unique changes and put them into a very simple chart. Here, let me show you. At the very top, we have three categories: reach, normal combos, and wall combos. These are the three major things that are affected by Mokujin's unique height. And on the left, we have positive, neutral, and negative. Now I'm sure you're thinking, what does he mean by this? Here, let me explain. Here's Mokujin compared to Brian Fury. As you can see, Mokujin has shorter reach, and that's a negative. This reach also affects his combos, Brian's bread and butter combos, whiff. So he can't do a max damage combo, he has to use weaker combos. So that's a negative for normal combos. But at the wall, Mokujin's height doesn't really affect any combos there. He doesn't gain or lose anything. So that's a point for neutral. And that's the data I'm using. And basically, I just repeat this process for all 56 characters Mokujin can copy. See, 56 times 3, that's 168 points to distribute amongst these three categories. And at the end, we'll see which one has the bigger number. So if he has more positive points, that means he's good. More negative, that means he's bad. And neutral as well, means just okay. And this is the method I'm going to use to see if Mokujin is objectively good or bad. I mean, he's a mimic character. Like, how else am I supposed to do it? Find a better method? I play fighting games. You think I have enough brain cells for that? So moving on, there's also a few characters that have some unique things about them. Let's like take a look at True Ogre real quick. His neutral is a little unique. As you can see, his snake arms don't extend, so all of his two moves are pretty much completely and utterly useless. Except for maybe two or three moves. But in exchange, he has longer legs. So his up back three is a ridiculously good move. So the shorter arms but the longer legs kind of cancel each other out, so I just put a point into neutral. Now a shorter size actually gives him some unique combos. So for instance, half circle forward, 2-1 plus 2 will usually connect after a bound. So the new combo pass means that it's a positive for normal combos. And at the wall, nothing really special, so just neutral. And that's the gist of things. I'm not going to go over all 56 characters because that would just be an hour straight of me droning on and like, oh, more reach, less reach, neutral. No thanks. It would just be me repeating my Mokujin Minute Guide, which is where I got all my data from. Check it out. It's a definitive Mokujin guide. Alright, enough talk. Let's see if Mokujin is good or bad. Oh no. My wood is below average.